okay? And it will be forwarded to your class teacher. So remember to attend all the classes. Okay, so we are starting Newton's third law. So Newton's first law, we all studied what it was.
You are every day posting videos on channel.
Yes, every day's video is being posted from the day one. You can find them from the day one, very day one. I have been posting. Okay, so Newton's first law. I'm not removing. They are all videos are posted in YouTube. I think today it's around 700 videos are there on this channel. Other one more channel was there earlier. Okay, so I'm not removing them. You can find them. Okay, so Newton's first law we have discussed. Newton's first law, what it was?
If your body is at rest, it will remain in rest unless an external force is applied.
Okay. If your body is in rest or if your body is in state of motion, uniform motion, it will continue to be in that state unless a force is required. So force is the cause. Force is required to change the state of the body. Understood? Force is required to bring the change. That was the Newton's first law. Okay. Second law, what it was? We have calculated the acceleration. So Newton's first law doesn't tell us when the force is being applied, what the change has been brought. That is how the velocity has changed or what change has been brought. So here we are measuring that quantity, that change quantity we are measuring. So what we are measuring here, acceleration we are measuring because there is a change in the velocity. So in second, we get the magnitude of the acceleration. How much acceleration is being produced in the body when force is being applied? This is our second law. F equal to ma, you remember? That's the second law. Okay. What about the third law? Today we are going to study the third law. In third law, we'll study how the force is being applied, how the force is acting on the body. Okay. So third law will discuss how the force is acting. Okay. For example, if force is applied, how it is acting, what is happening with the body, how the body is going to react. Okay, we are going to study the third law, that is how the force is acting on the body. Okay, so in third law, we are going to study that one. Okay, so in third law, Newton's third law is what? To every action, there is an equivalent. There is an equivalent opposite reaction. That means magnitude is same. Opposite reaction. That means action and reactions are there. Both are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. This is clear? Both are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. That means action is nothing but force. Reaction is nothing but force. They are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. This is Newton's third law. Okay. So we can take few examples. For example, on a table, a book is lying. Okay. So this book will apply some force. Which force it will apply?
Gravitational force.
Gravitational force equal to its weight. That gravitational force will be equal to its weight, mg. So there is a force acting downward. It means because of this force, this book will continue to move downward. Yes or no? If this force is acting on this book will continue to move downward, but it is at rest. What is the reason of the book being at rest? That is, there is some force opposing this force. There is some force opposing this weight force, this weight. Equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. Then only the resultant force on the book will be zero. So the book is applying force downward, but since it is lying on the table, so we can say the book is applying weight, that is this force on the table. In reaction, the table will apply force on the book. And that force we call it as reaction force. You have studied normal reaction force. That is normal to the surface in contact. It is the reaction force. So this is the action force. That is weight of the body. And reaction force is being applied by the table on the book. So book is applying force on the table. In turn, in return, the table is applying force on the book. Okay. So book, we are considering action force. So reaction is generated by the table. Okay. These are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. That's why the resultant force on the book will be zero. And therefore, body remains at rest. Therefore, body remains at rest. Is this clear?
Sir, can you again tell?
Yes, sir.
Again.
Okay.
Sir, can you again tell?
Okay. Okay. So this time, consider a book only. You are having a book. Okay. This is the book. So it's in the air. Which force is being applied? Which force it will apply the book?
Gravitational force.
Will be applied. There will be gravitational force on the book, and that will be equal to its weight. That force that will be equal to its weight. So what will happen? This book will continue to move downwards since gravitational force is acting. This book will continue to move downward. Okay. But now consider it lying on the table. That is, it is on the table. I'm using green color for the table. Okay. So this is the table. Okay. It is lying on the table. Okay. So you can see there's a continuous force downward equivalent to weight. The force acting downward is the weight of the book. So if weight is acting, it means the book should continue to go downwards since force is acting. If force is acting on the book, it should go downward, but it is lying at rest position. Why? Because as you put the book, it applies force on the table. Because this book wants to go downward. It wants to go downward. So it applies force on the table. In reaction, what will happen? This table will apply force on the book. In which direction? In the upward direction. In return, this book, this table will apply force in this direction. Okay. Or you can consider here in this direction. So this table is applying how much force on the book? Equivalent to its weight. This is the action. Okay. In return, the table is applying force on the book. That is the reaction force. And both of them are equal in magnitude but opposite direction. So we can say resultant force on the book is how much? It's zero.
Zero.
Resultant force on the book will be zero. Therefore, body remains at rest. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Because yes. Resultant force. There is no force. We can say resultant force on the book acting on the book is zero. That's why body remains at rest. Okay. Now, if I remove the table, what will happen? There will be no reaction force. Only the weight, it will go downward. So there is resultant force will be equivalent to its weight and it will go downward. Understood now? So
yes,
to every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Okay. This is clear. Okay. Have you considered how you are able to walk on the ground?
Yes, sir.
What you are pushing? Are you pushing the ground backward?
Yes, sir.
No, sir. No. Sir, we are pushing us outward, that forwards.
Okay, see how it is happening. For example, okay, consider it as a shoe. Okay. Okay, now see what happens. This is your shoe. Okay, how you walk? You push the ground backward. In this direction you push. While you walk, you can see, you can feel the pressure. You push the ground backward. Or you can see it when you walk in the sand. Sand is being pushed downward. You can see?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes. If you're walking, for example, you're walking on the road, you are pushing it downward. So this is the action force. For example, this is the contact. This is the action force applied by you. You are applying force on the ground. In turn, what happens? The ground pushes you. The ground pushes you in this direction. So this is the action force. This is the reaction force. So the shoe is applying force on the ground. The ground is applying force on the shoe. So action force. And this is the reaction. They are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. And because of that, ground pushing you back, you move forward. Okay. In more detail, we'll discuss it later. Okay. For time being, just consider this. Okay. We'll take the components and all. We'll discuss in detail afterwards. So you're applying force on the ground applies force on you, and you move forward. Okay. For example, you are walking on the sand. In sand, what happens? When you push the sand, a little bit like this is formed. A depression is formed in the sand. Why this happens? Because you are pushing the sand downward, backward. Yes or no? In this direction, you are pushing the sand. That's why it happens. Since it is concrete, so it is not, no depression forms and it pushes you back. Okay. As well, it pushes you back. But some depression is formed. So it's little bit, okay, that is something more weak. Okay. And you want, you're little bit uncomfortable to walk forward because this force will be a little bit less because some force will come. Okay, see here, for example, you apply the force here. So some force will be wasted in doing the work against in pushing this downward, that is in depression, creating the depression. So whatever action force and reaction force, they will be less in magnitude. Okay, so for example, you applied the force. So a part of this force applied will go in creating the depression. Okay, and reaction that will be applied will be a little bit less. So you feel a little bit difficulty in walking on the sand. Okay. This is some practical example. Leave it for time. Okay. So just consider you are pushing the ground backward. The ground pushes you back. Okay. There is an action force and reaction force by the ground on your shoe. And that's how you walk forward. Okay. This is clear?
Yes.
So what you are saying? Action force was there, action is there, and reaction. Are they acting on the same body or different bodies?
On two different bodies.
Different bodies.
On two different bodies. You can see when book was lying on the table, book was applying force on the table. Okay. In return, the table was applying force on the book. So they were acting on, they were applied on different bodies. So both were acting on different bodies. Okay. This is clear. Now there's one more example given in your book. We'll consider that one. Okay. This time we take spring balance. Okay. You all have seen the spring balance. It is used to weigh the goods or the items, you can say. So what's there inside the spring balance? What's there inside the spring balance? Spring is there. So see, it is like this. It has the ring on the top. It has the ring on the top. And there's a groove. And it is marked 0 kg, 2 kg, 4 kg, like this, up to 8 or 10, or maybe depending on that kgs. Okay. Mainly it's weight. This is calibrated in terms of kgs. Okay. Mainly it's the weight. Because weight is the mg will be there, but it is calibrated in terms of kgs, that is equivalent to particular newton, that is weight, this much must be the kg. Okay, that is how it is calibrated, and there is a spring inside it. Okay, a spring is there. Okay, okay, 1 minute. I will use a different color. Okay. So blue color we are using for the spring. Spring is there. Okay. And there is a hook, okay? And this portion is attached. 1 minute, I will draw like this. Okay. This end portion is attached, and this one here we have the hook. Okay, like this. So, whenever we try to pull the hook, what will happen? The spring will get compressed, spring will get compressed or not. The spring is going to get compressed. So for example, 2 kg mass we have put here. So it will compress and the pointer will be here at the 2 kgs. Okay. This will compress. The spring is going to compress. Okay. So in which direction the force will be? In this direction, we are compressing the spring. So force is acting in the downward direction. Force will be acting in this downward direction. Is this clear? The spring?
Yes.
0 kgs, 2, 4, 8, 9, 10, like this. Okay. So as you put the weight here, the spring gets compressed. More the weight, more the compression will be there. So it has the ring on one on top and hook at bottom. Okay. Now this time we'll be using two spring balances. Okay. So how we are going to? So on one side we have the wall and there's a hook in wall. Okay. On wall we have the hook. Now this ring of one spring is being attached to the hook on the wall, and we have the spring balance here. Okay. So 0, 2, 4, like this, 4, 8, 10. Okay. And here we have the hook. Okay. This is our one spring balance. Okay. We name it as B. This is our B spring balance. Okay. Other spring balance as well will be here, and hook to hook they are connected. Okay. Hook to hook they are connected. Spring balance, and this is the hook of this one. Okay, so 0 will be here. It's the ring here. 0, 2, 4, 8, 10. Okay, this is our A spring balance. Okay, so we made an arrangement such that this one of the spring balance ring is connected, is attached to the hook in the wall. Okay, the hook of this B spring balance is connected with the hook of the other spring balance. Okay, we are going to apply force on this ring, ring of weight. Okay, we are going to apply force. That is, we are going to pull it. We are going to pull this spring. Okay, so see here, what happens when you are pulling the ring? What will happen? This is going to, the spring will get compressed here. See, a spring get compressed here. The spring will move this direction. Okay, some weight will be shown here. Okay, spring will be here at this position, like this. It get compressed. Okay, similarly, here as well, it will show some way. This spring is as well will get compressed, will get compressed. So both the springs are getting compressed like this. Okay, spring is there, getting compressed. Here as well, spring getting compressed. Okay, this you have understood? Okay, so when you are pulling it, both the spring balance will show the same mark. That is same weight they are going to show. Same reading they are showing. Reading is better term. Okay. Both are going to show the same reading. Okay. So see what is happening. When you are pulling the spring, this spring you are pulling. Okay. As you're pulling this spring balance, what will happen? This spring will pull this spring. Spring A will pull the spring B. Okay. That's what will happen. Spring B will get compressed. Spring B will get compressed. As you are pulling this spring of A, this spring will get compressed. So we are doing action here. Action we are doing. That is, force is being applied here. Force, which direction it is being applied? It is being getting compressed. It means in this direction force is being applied. On what it is being applied? On B spring. And because of what it is applied? Due to A. This is force on spring B due to spring A. So it is like this. If you are writing FBA, it means force on B body due to A body. Is this clear? Force on B due to A. It means force on B due to A. Due to A. So we are pulling the spring A, okay? And this spring pulls spring B, okay? So A spring is pulling spring B. So spring get compressed. This is the force direction acting. Force on B due to A. Okay. Now see what will happen. This spring will pull spring A. This spring will pull spring A. So this time force direction will be this one. And what we'll name it? FAB. Force on A due to B. Okay. This is the action. Then this will be the reaction. And both will be equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Okay, have you understood? As you pull the spring A, this spring will pull spring B. Okay, spring B get compressed. So this is why how it is happening. Force on B due to A in this direction. It is being pulled, force on B due to A. And now this spring, what it will do? It will pull the spring B towards it. It will pull the spring B. So spring B, it will pull the spring A. Spring A get compressed. So there is a force on spring A. Force on spring A due to B. This is the reaction force. Action force, reaction force. When it compresses, it pulls the spring A towards it. Okay, this is clear. So their magnitudes, FAB equal to FBA. They are equal, but their direction, if we consider, this is the magnitude, they are equal. But if we consider the directions, that will be opposite. Have you understood this one? This reaction force is in opposite direction to FAB. This minus sign came from the direction. Okay. Or one example I can give. For example, you are catching a ball. So ball is going to apply force on your hand. If that force is F, as we have discussed in numerical 10, that force applied by the ball is F. How much force you have, reaction force you have to apply to stop the ball?
F only, but in opposite direction.
But in opposite direction. That means if it is F, you will apply minus F. Here minus denotes the direction, that is opposite direction. Understood? So if it is applying, this ball is applying 30 Newton force. How much you have to apply? Minus 30.
Minus 30 Newton.
That means magnitude is same, minus, but opposite in direction. Minus 30 Newton. This is clear? Okay. So we'll take afterwards that numerical 10. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So tabletop we have already discussed. We discuss it again once. So emphasize on concept rather than this experiment, okay? Okay, sometimes the student feels a little bit tough to remember this experiment, spring balances. Okay, so best thing is just emphasize on the concept. You can leave the experiment, okay? Because there are many other examples as well where you can show the experiment, okay? These things. So examples, few examples we are taking. So first, it was the book we already taken. This is the book and table, okay? So which force it is applying this book? Equal to its?
Action force.
Weight.
Weight.
This is the action force. This is the action force. Okay, 1 minute, I have to attach the charger. So this is the action force. This action force is applied on what? On the table it is applied. The book is applying weight on the table. That is, it is applying force on the table. In reaction, what table will do? It will apply force on the book. And that force will be called as? It will apply in the opposite direction. Okay. Here only. In the opposite direction, it will apply. Okay. These two forces, this is the action force, that is weight of the book. And this will be the reaction force by the book, by the table. So see, a book is applying force on the table. And table is applying force on the book. Okay. That means force, these forces are acting on different bodies. Weight of the book is applied on table, whereas reaction force is applied on the book. So these forces, action and reaction forces, they are applied on two different bodies. They are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Okay. First example is clear. Second example, pushing a wall. Okay. Have you tried pushing a wall? So what happens if you apply force on the wall? That means you are doing action on the wall. You are applying force on the wall. In turn, what happens? Do you feel the force on your palm? When you apply force on the wall, you feel the force on the wall, palm. So that force is reaction force. In turn, wall applies force on your palm. Okay? In turn, mole applies force on your palm. Okay? So you feel the force. These two forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. The palm applies force on wall. In turn, the wall applies force on your palm. They are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Next, you have seen the motion of the boat from the shore. Okay? For example, this is the shore. And here we have the boat. Okay? If boat is there, water has to be there. Okay? And this is the boatman. Okay? Now see here, how this boatman make the boat to move from the shore. Mainly a bamboo stick is being used. So what this boatman will do? This boatman will push the shore. He is applying force on the shore. He will try to push the shore. Okay, in turn, what the shore will do? The shore will push the bamboo. The shore will push the bamboo. In turn, will push the man. In turn, will push the boat.
Sir, but how shore will push the bamboo?
Okay, consider it. Apply the force. If you are on the wall like this, try pushing it. Right? If this is the wall, try it. You will be pushed backward if you are applying force on the wall. You can try that one. So see here, for example, if it is paper, what will happen? You are applying force on the paper, but paper cannot apply that much reaction force equivalent to the force applied by you. What will happen? It will tear and you will fall. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So see here, in reality, what happens? If this is a mud or something like this, you are applying force on the shore. Little bit it will penetrate till it get compressed much. Now, you cannot compress the sand much, okay? And the shore will apply the force. So what will happen as you apply force? You are being pushed backward. And in turn, you are attached with the boat pushed backward, okay? There is as well here as well action-reaction happening. At every point, action-reaction happening. If you consider each point as one body. Okay, so you push the shore, in turn, the shore pushes you. The bamboo stick pushes, in turn pushes you, in turn pushes the board away from the shore. Have you understood this one?
Sir?
Yes.
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 Sir, is there any action reaction force when we push the board with the bamboo stick, when we move the board?
Ball and bamboo stick. Okay. Yes, there is action reaction. Yes, there is. You apply force on the ball, okay? In turn, ball applies force on the okay?
Sir, I am asking about, sir, bamboo stick and water. When we move the boat, then, sir.
Okay. So this is the shore. You are applying force on the shore to the bamboo stick. So see what is happening. You have the bamboo stick. You are applying force on the bamboo stick. In turn, this bamboo stick applies force on the shore. So we can say we are applying force on the shore. Okay. Now, as you apply force on the shore, this shore will apply force on the bamboo stick. And in turn, this bamboo stick will apply force on you. And yes?
Sir, I am asking that when we are moving in the boat, and at that time, sir, the action-reaction force between water and bamboo stick is there.
Water and bamboo stick.
Yes, sir. Is there any action-reaction force?
Okay, see here it is like this. Here action-reaction forces are there. Okay. At here, action-reaction forces are there. Okay. Then here in boat, wherever you are in contact with the boat, action-reaction forces are there. Then the boat and water, there are action-reaction forces. So this is how. There are series of action-reaction. As well, if you consider in your body, at every point, there is action and reaction forces. So from head to toe, there is action and reaction forces happening. Is this clear now? So we are having a series connected. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So in simple words, we can say when we apply force on the shore in turn will push you backward. Push the bamboo stick, push you backward. Push this boat away from the shore. Okay? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, so sir. Till now, whatever we studied, go through it once. If you have doubt, you can ask it now or tomorrow in class, you can ask, okay? And remember to take all the classes, okay? I'll be taking the attendance. I'll be forwarding to your class teacher as well. So remember to take all the classes, okay?
Sir, if we move the bamboo in the opposite direction of the shore, then we will reach